mind about that you're conducting it for?
Yeah, so basically DevFest is an abbreviation for Developers Festival. We celebrate something with developers. So we invite a lot of developers across the industry. We share the knowledge from expertise from the industry. Basically, we invite a lot of speakers, mentors, and somebody has done something in their career. So they come, they share their knowledge and their experience with the rest of the developer community. And that's how people from the Pune or maybe in nearby area, they learn a lot from this.
So since how many years are you doing this DevFest?
So DevFest, basically GDG started from 2011 end or maybe 12 started. Then it's almost 8 years, it is 8th edition we are doing that DevFest. And this is the largest event we have done so far. So basically this year is the, you can say we received almost 5,000 plus registrations, and in fact we have invited more than 1,000 developers here for the event.
So from the developers that are invited, how many are women?
So basically more than 30-35% female participants are there. You can see across there are a lot of women. In fact, not only developers, but there are some good entrepreneurs, women entrepreneurs who have done something in their career. In fact, those are also part of this event. In fact, a lot of speakers also. We try to maintain the ratio. We try to work on diversity and inclusion. So basically, we try to invite a lot of female entrepreneurs and female developers for this event.
So you're basically promoting equal opportunities.
We are trying to make it, and in fact, we are doing or maybe working hard to make it.
So this DevFest, apart from Pune, what other cities does it happen?
So there are almost close to 40 chapters across India and more than 1,000 chapters across world. Everybody is doing DevFest during this season. The season is starting between September to end. It will end by October end. So there are 2.5 months span where almost 1,000 cities across world will be doing, and Pune, from India there will be 40 plus chapters.
So where does Pune stand in this? Like you said that Pune is one of the most popular destinations.
Yeah, so Pune is one of the, you can say, most prominent destination who is most active community or most active chapter of the GDG. So you will find around 10,000 plus active members associated with GDG Pune.
Okay.
And yeah.
So these 10,000 members are all Punekars, or you have people from outside Pune also joining GDG, from the surrounding cities or villages?
So you will be surprised, basically across India you can say, and in fact from outside of India also people are visiting this event. So we have kept quota of 15% for outside of Pune, or in fact outside of Maharashtra state. And it is, we have got almost 350 people who have shown interest to attend this event. Due to logistic things, we have kept it 150, and everybody has come.
Okay, that's good. Now talking about this event, what's happening today at this event? If you can just give me a brief spread.
Yeah, so this event we are targeting, or the theme is basically AI, ML and the cloud. So because these are the buzzword in the industry, and a lot of things are happening around the artificial intelligence, machine learning and the cloud technology. So we have kept that as our theme, and most of the speakers and the content which you will be see around. So it is focused over the artificial intelligence, machine learning and the cloud emerging technologies, you can say.
Okay. So Mahaveer, you are leading the GDG Pune chapter.
Yeah.
Right? So what are the changes that you plan to bring into this chapter? How do you plan to expand this chapter? Make it more reachable and accessible?
We usually do events in Pune, so basically at least one event in a month.
Mm-hmm.
So we try to do it in different part of cities, at least we try to cover the different, we have divided city into 8 parts.
Okay.
And we try to do event in every other part of city, and we try to invite lot of, you can say, not only developers, but somebody has achieved something in their career. So we try to invite them as a, you can say, motivation and something for the attendees. That's how we are trying to expand, and we are reaching out to a lot of companies, a lot of institutions, where we can go and train there, or maybe share knowledge with their existing development team, so that they become expert and probably they can share knowledge in based on their teammates.
Right, so you basically are contributing to knowledge transformations from between the stakeholders of technologies.
Yeah, you can say. Basically, our agenda is, see, I'll not name the country, but you might see there are countries who are very prominent in specific era or specific thing.
Mm-hmm.
We want India to dominate something in specific thing. So we are targeting, India is based off, you can say, software hub. Everybody call India as an emerging or leading country in software. So we are trying to make it much more vibrant, much more advanced in terms of technology.
Okay.
We are trying to make it from ourselves, we are starting, and probably from our city, then we are expanding gradually. So this is the agenda.
Any specific innovations or achievements of GDG that you would like to spell out? Something that you have driven also?
So, in fact, there are a lot of achievements. You could see a lot of students, and you could see a lot of developers here who have done a lot of innovative things. So there are a couple of stories recently covered by Google officially. So students who have started attending events and who have started contributing to community, they have built really innovative products with automobile, with water consumption and everything. So these features has been already covered by Google, and probably by the next month or maybe by the end of next month, it will be featured on every social channel by Google.
That's good to know. Thanks, Mahaveer. It was a pleasure speaking to you.
Thank you very much.
Thank you. This once again at DevFest 2019. Thank you.